In the year 2000, the readers of dance magazines, as you mentioned, Dance Magazine, were asked to name the 10 greatest dancers of the 20th century. And there was, the list came out, and it had, of course, Maria on it, and Baryshnikov, and Margot Fonteyn, and Paloma. Oh, yeah, I love these, but I want pointe shoes. I don't know why I never said that. And I said, I want pointe shoes. And so my mom took me to my teacher. And from the very first day, I loved it. I loved it. I never missed a class. I'll be sick, and I will escape my house, and my mom's like, oh, you're sick, you can't go, and I will go anyway. And yes, and that's something that even today, I feel that way. That same passion that I felt when I was 7 years old. Mm-hmm. Exactly the same way. Yeah. So yeah, ABT was my dream company. Always, always, always. So just to, and that's why when I was in New York, when I was at SAB, I used to, you know, go to the Met and Cecily Yen that was a guest, or Carlo Fracci, and it was just the dream, just to be in New York and be able to actually see live performance for when I was, you know, in Argentina, just watching videos. It was pretty amazing. So when I got the chance to audition, just because I heard there were auditions and I just went, it was an amazing experience. Like, yes, of course I'll go, but I never expected to, coming from Argentina, being 15 years old, and never expected to get into the company, but I was just dying to be there. So when Jane Herman actually just came after class, said, okay, we'll give you a contract for the Coupe de Ballet, it's one of the experiences that even today is, it just changed my life. People ask me, like, how, which one is your favorite role? And I don't have favorite, I think all of them. Some are very close to my personality, so I feel like very close that I could bring my personality on the stage. And some were so opposite that it was so much fun to do something completely the opposite of what you are. So everything is really interesting. But what dance means for me. And I think it's a way of life. It taught me how to live my life. It's about intensity, it's about passion, it's about not just with dance. That's my life. That's how I live life. That's how I don't just go through life like whatever. Everything is intensity. And some people, you know, maybe it's better. They don't, you know, they don't go ups and downs. Maybe if they have something that happens, then something good happens. Everything is, you know, it's intense, and I like it that way. Like, oh, when you get to a point, you're like, you're over it, and I'm retiring, and I'm still, you know, waiting for that moment to happen that I'm over it. I mean, it's not happening. So. I think it's better that way. So
it's much better that. Yeah.
And like I said before, it's a way of life, and I never really care about. I mean, I think it's wonderful that the audience and the prices and the things, and but that's not why I dance. I dance because I love it. I don't need to be the center of attention. I dance because it's fulfilling to me. And I can do the same thing for now to watch other people. I go out front to see the company or to see other companies. It's really fulfilling. So I don't need to do it myself. I can enjoy other people's